I'm going to do four sort of semi-frames on that wall and then build up. Then I want to do something really huge on that wall and possibly to match it on these two as well.
Well, Ben, I really find the title Inhabit quite an evocative title for this major multi-part suite of works. For me, it works on a number of levels, but I'd be really interested to know where you're coming from with adopting that title.
Sure. I had the idea of this concept of inhabiting something, the way Australians, my Irish blood running through my veins and calling myself an Australian, has inhabited the place that we call Australia. And my wife, actually came up with the term inhabit, so I can't claim that, but it nailed the idea of what I was working towards, trying to achieve the idea of not only being in a room with paintings, but looking at paintings that are about the concept of us having inhabited a country for only 200 years. So very much about ideas of identity and my own identity fitted in with you know, the first white European Australians through to, you know, a self-portrait of myself.
Sure. I mean, obviously the suite of works include images of the devil and then Captain Cook. And I know when I've read about this series before, you talk about almost inhabiting those characters as well in the process of making this work. Mm. And then it was quite a kind of emotional experience for you. My understanding is it's sort of not just about national identity, perhaps, and our own history, but also for you entering those identities and characters in history.
It was definitely sort of the most confronting suite of paintings I've made. Not only just trying to animate from one to the next, but having myself in it, and the image of the devil is from an image of the devil that I used to draw when I was at school. This cartoonish, like, fanged devil creature on the front of my science folder at a Catholic boys' school, and the sort of the levels of meaning of that character. So all of, in a way, it's a self-portrait of myself as a white Australian as well, definitely. And it was a very confronting thing to do, particularly the self-portraits. And in a way too, where I was last year personally, I guess it was a difficult year for me. And it was about that experience of inhabiting Ben, myself. To inhabit, I guess the whole idea of inhabiting is that you're a being inside an ecosystem rather than a part of the ecosystem. So the fencing wire and the cast bronze components, from a distance it's a very beautiful object, but when you get up close to it you can see that it's covered in very sharp bronze skulls and fencing wire and huge padlocks. And the cast bronze blackberry branch, and the idea of putting, almost emotionally putting yourself into that cage is quite a dark sort of idea. And the paintings are all looking in at it, so it's like they're all inhabiting. This symbolises the emotional headspace of the characters on the wall. the wall drawings I've been doing in the studio for quite a few years, and they're based loosely, the first time I did it, based on that very lowbrow graphic image on the side of big trucks. The trucks all have this sort of quite beautiful and geometric shapes with dots on the side of the cabin, like the identity of the man sitting within it. And I started doing those very lowbrow drawings around my paintings, and this was a very direct continuation of that process, but in three dimensions and made from really sort of solid materials that'll last forever. It's all turned steel, high tensile fencing wire and bronze, which will outlast me.
In your earlier work, sometimes in your paintings you would morph two images together within the one picture plane, whereas here with this 16-part series, you've actually inhabited each canvas and then removed yourself and moved and morphed on to the next piece. And I feel like that's quite an interesting development in this body of work. Were you conscious of that when you were painting?
Yeah, my first job out of school was as an animator, as an assistant trainee animator. So, and I'd do the in-betweening between Bugs Bunny. Then the animator would do one second, and I'd learn to fill in the middle parts. And I found it incredibly tedious and difficult. I couldn't stand it. It was very not what I was built to do. But my idea really came from that experience of animating myself into, first of all, Captain Cook into the devil. Captain Cook is the symbol of the beginning of the end of that idea of Eden and Indigenous harmony and all those sorts of ideas. And then to keep animating it and animate it right around a room. Was actually really, really, really difficult to make them make sense in that
sure,
sort of
sure,
order.
Sure. And yet in this series here, that sequence works very well. Mm. And it's interesting to note that the end point is a self-portrait of yourself, but it's completely in a negative form. Mm. It's almost as though you have removed yourself from that final lens, if you like, of this series.
I guess sitting in a studio with these works for 8 months, you can't help but end up being affected by what you're doing, the project that you set yourself. Mm-hmm. Not only the physical task of making the objects, but the concept of what I'm thinking about, the research that I'm doing on the internet about the Nathaniel Dance portrait and the portraits and where they come from, and
yes,
and reading Cook's diaries about his first intervention into Indigenous Australia, the violence of it.
Yes,
sure. So I guess they're pretty brutal self-portraits. I didn't mean them to be quite so dark, but they are. I guess with this body of work, and you've picked up on it, I think people will pick up on the fact that I am, in a way, it's a fairly critical comment on our reordering of history.
Yes.
And to make a comment like that, that is based in an ideological sort of romantic ideological belief in perfection that's not existent in our community, the only way I find to do it honestly is to include myself.
Yes.
And I am a willing participant. You know, I've lived the life. I've lived the life as a white European in Australia. So to paint myself in a brutally honest way, I think then not one part of it is that I sort of shield myself from criticism about making these comments because
yes.
I'm saying that I'm part of it.
Yes.
Very directly,
yes.
I'm
yes.
a part of it.
Yes.
But also, I guess it's about... it's just made sense in the studio. Thanks for putting it in here. It's amazing.